Okay, so first let's take a fresh look at what it is that women are attracted to and why you're attracted to certain women. Generally speaking, one of the most important lessons and one of the most important topics and the reason why I put it first in this book is understanding the difference between the gender roles, male and female gender roles. The reason why this is so important is because it used to be that you could play only your gender role associated with your sex. So if you were a guy, you had to play the male gender role. And if you were a girl, you had to play the female gender role. Otherwise, you wouldn't survive. That was a long, 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 long time ago. It hasn't been like that for a very long time. And now there's something else at play. There's something that changes our survival. It's not survival of the fittest anymore. I mean, weak men do survive, procreate, and create new families of more weak men. It does happen. But there's something that they, physically weak at least, there's something that they are doing that's different now. There's something that is more important than being physically strong. And so we'll go into that during this chapter, and that's what I want to illuminate a little bit for you so you get a pretty good idea about what actually is attractive, what makes you attractive as a man. Now, the reason why I'm talking about you want to learn about gender roles is because men and women who are playing their gender role are always attracted to someone who's playing the opposing gender role. So if you're playing the male gender role, you are attracting a woman who's playing the female gender role. If you're playing the female gender role, which a lot of guys actually are, you will attract women that are playing the male gender role. Whether or not that's what you want doesn't really matter. That's what you're going to attract. So regardless of what you want in a relationship, what you're trying to get, as long as you're playing the female gender role, you'll always attract a woman who's playing the male gender role. And I'm going to go into what those gender roles are clearly, and I'm going to shed some light on that so you can understand how to play the male gender role properly so that you naturally attract the kind of women that you will naturally be attracted to, instead of attracting the same women that you're eventually lose attraction for you, or that you lose attraction for eventually, or if you're not attracting the kind of women that let's say that you don't think are as attractive as what you deserve, then this will help clear that up, and understanding gender roles will open a massive door for you to allow you to meet a lot of new women. Again, probably. One of the most important core values of being a badass with women in general. So the old idea of the male gender role was to be a provider-protector. That meant that a provider meant that you could go out and you could either hunt and gather, basically, and kill animals and cook and do things like this, and then provide for your family. But the protector meant that you were big and strong and you could fend off potential threats. The female used to be that they were nurturers. They had to take care of the children and basically rear young. But that's changed a lot. And in case you haven't noticed, look around you now. How many women do you see that are attractive that have no sign of wanting to have kids at the moment? Probably several. And how many guys do you know that are skinny, frail, even frail looking? Think of like rock stars. They have absolutely no way to provide or protect, really. I mean, they're think of like a really reckless rock star. The funny thing about that is they are naturally very, very attractive, but they're not strong whatsoever. And their responsibilities, their ability to provide, is so low that they can't even provide for themselves most of the time, and they're only up when the music's good and down when the music's down. So how come they have women crawling all over them? Then why does that matter? And the answer to that lies in the secret element that has changed what our gender roles really are. And that secret element is society, social rules. Social rules have changed what a provider, protector, and what a nurturer really is. So instead of being a provider, protector, Now, in order to fulfill the male gender role, you have to be a social provider and a social protector. That means that instead of doing all the providing yourself, where you go out and you actually get the food, bring it back, and make it and provide for the family, you have to be able to provide socially. You don't have to make a dime in order to provide socially. That means that people need you or like you so much that they want to give you things that help you survive. This typically is much more powerful than having a whole lot of money. Think about it this way. Why are women attracted to men who have a whole lot of money? That's a big question, right? Think about the true answer to this question. There cannot be one exception to this truth, otherwise it's not true. So think about this for a second. What does it mean if you have a whole lot of money? Well, that means that you had to earn a whole lot of money, obviously. How do you earn a whole lot of money? Well, you have a powerful position doing something, or you lead something, right? Okay, well, if you have a powerful position, then that means that you are probably a leader of some sort of organization or some sort of trend or group, or you're a director of some big, large group of people. So if you're a director, that means that you're a leader. If you're a leader, that means that people are following you, right? If people are following you, that means that they get some value out of being around you. That means that being around you makes them more valuable. It makes them more valuable, and it makes them happier. So when women see men who have a lot of money, they automatically assume, which isn't necessarily the best assumption, but they automatically assume that that person gives a bunch of other people value, and that's why they have a lot of money. But what's more important than having a lot of money in a relationship is that one character, that one characteristic that allows you to gain the money in the first place. But unfortunately now, that's not a very good – money's not a very good indicator, because in the past you used to have to have a bunch of people like you in order to make money. But now, especially because of the internet, you can make money online without ever talking to a single person in your life. You can never correspond personally with a single person and make millions of dollars online. That's just the truth. That's how it is. So that's not a very good indicator. So women are more and more starting to push away the idea of thinking that money is an indicator, and they're starting more and more to understand that it was what that money was an indication of that they're attracted to. They're attracted to that quality of someone who gives other people value, that makes other people feel better and more important. And that is what they're attracted to as women. So that's why women are like a phenomenal talent scouts, because they go, they can recognize this quality, and if you have the potential, they're attracted to you. It doesn't necessarily mean that you have fulfilled that potential, it just means that you have the potential to be rich someday, because you have the one quality that every rich person has, and that is you make other people feel more important and valuable when you're around them. Now, women aren't playing the typical or the traditional female gender role either. Nurturing isn't necessarily necessary. There are nannies, there are plenty of other people that can do the nurturing for you. What we're attracted to now is called empathy, or an empathizer. The female gender role now is to feel what other people feel. That's their gender role. Now, the crucial thing here is that if you do your gender role and you let them do their gender role, your relationship will most likely work out. You'll attract women who naturally want to play the female gender role, and that relationship will most likely work out. But if you don't let them play their gender role, or you don't play your gender role, that relationship will not work out. Eventually, you will be upset basically with the idea that they're playing your gender role, and that's called gender role reversal, and we'll get into that in a bit. Now, I like to say that there are two basic parts to your personality. There's the little boy in you, and then there's the man in you. Now, it's very natural that the little boy in you would want to feel all the time. And I know that a moment ago I was explaining about how it's the female gender role, and the typically the woman's job, if she's playing the female gender role, to feel, to be openly emotional, to be able to express how she feels about everything. And if you want to play the male gender role, does that mean that you can't feel? Well, not necessarily, but you're not allowed to make emotional-based decisions. If you start making emotionally-based decisions, then she can't make those emotionally based decisions for herself. She has to start, quote unquote, steering the boat. She has to lead the relationship. She has to stop feeling and think logically. And that will force her out of her female gender role, and then she'll start to blame you for everything. So you don't want to do that. But the naturally, the little boy in you is going to want to feel. But that little boy can never make decisions without first getting the approval of the man part of you. So basically what that means is that you're allowed to feel if you want to. You're allowed to feel all you want to. But you can't let that emotion influence your decision-making process when it comes to a relationship. You have to always be very logical when it comes to making decisions that will better the relationship in the future. And it's your significant other, it's this girl's job, this woman's job that you're dating or that you're in a relationship, whatever. It's her job to solicit an emotion out of you at some point and to make you feel happy. And it's her job to feel happy. So how do you very, very, very clearly play the male gender role? That's the big question. Because whenever you are in a default stage, let's say that you're walking around just meeting random people, whatever default mode you're in is the mode in which you are going to attract women. So if you are constantly playing the female gender role in default and you only play the male gender role when you're with someone that you're already dating, then naturally when people see you walking around playing the female gender role, they're not going to be attracted to you if they want to play the female gender role. So if a woman is there and she wants to play the female gender role, then she's probably not going to be attracted to you. In fact, you're going to start attracting women that are playing the male gender role by default, which is not typically what you want. So you're going to have to learn how to play the male gender role as a default. It has to be very clear that you're getting this across to people. So again, if you lose control of your emotions, she won't feel safe enough to lose control of her emotions. And it is her right as a woman who's playing the female gender role to empathize or feel in an uninhibited way. So if she has to stop feeling and quote-unquote steer the boat, then she won't feel like a woman. You're not going to make her feel like a woman. If she doesn't feel like a woman, then she'll eventually leave you, or she'll become angry and blame you for all of her problems, and you actually are to blame because it's your job to make sure that you're steering the boat, that you are playing the male gender role always so that she can feel comfortable playing the female gender role. You also have to reward her for playing the female gender role. You have to learn to understand what qualities are the qualities of a woman who's playing the female gender role, and then make sure that you address those qualities. Anytime she wants to feel smaller, dainty, fragile, weak, protected, anything that basically makes you feel like you're playing your gender role better and allows her to feel her gender role will make your relationship stronger and make you more attractive. So ultimately, don't worry about trying to feel what she feels all the time or trying to connect with her yet. Having an emotional association, an emotional connection, which we'll get into a little bit later in this book, is another skill set that does not involve you losing control of your emotions ever. So keep that in mind. So imagine that love is a bit like magic, like, you know, you're doing a magic trick. Your job, if love is like a magic trick, your job is to create the magic trick. Your job is to make this quarter disappear over and over and over again. And her job is to appreciate it and to feel amazed, like she has no idea how you did that. And it's amazing, and do it again, because it's awesome. You know, another way to think of it is, if feeling and openly expressing emotions is like chasing a butterfly around, so let's say that all the guys who are very openly emotional about everything are like chasing butterflies around, and so are the women. Her job is to chase around the butterfly and enjoy how beautiful it is. Your job is to move everything out of her way so she feels safe doing this. So basically, the idea is that she can feel up until the point where that feeling will actually hurt her in a very negative way. You only stop her if, you know, metaphorically, she's about to chase this butterfly off a cliff. if what she's feeling is going to harm her, you, or the relationship, then you have to stop her. But don't stop her until then. One of the major misconceptions that men have is that women are speaking the same language as them, and they're not. Women are not speaking the same language as you. Women are speaking from their point of view as playing the female gender role. You don't have to feel the same way that you do. Things that they say don't have to make complete sense to you, and you don't need to agree with it. All you need to do is understand that she's speaking a different language than you, and it's not necessarily going to be the same, but because she wants a different outcome for herself than you want for yourself. You want to feel more like a man. So the things that you do that make you feel more like a man aren't going to make her feel better as a woman. So the thing, and the things that she does that, you know, make her feel good as a woman aren't necessarily going to make you feel good as a man. You probably don't get super excited. I mean, you may, but you probably don't get super excited about going on a shopping spree. You know, well, a lot of women are very excited about that. You may not watch soap operas, but a lot of women are very excited about soap operas. You don't have to like all the same things that women do. That's a very weak and manipulative way of trying to get into a woman's heart. Instead, you have to embrace your manhood, embrace your male gender role, the new male gender role. And above all, don't ever budge on your gender role. Gender role testing happens constantly. She will constantly be testing you to see if you truly want to play the male gender role or if you are going to be able to do it. If you pass the test, she'll feel safer being a woman. If not, you'll get what's called gender role reversal. Gender role reversal is essentially the beginning of the end of your relationship. So basically what happens is you'll get constant tests where she will seem like she wants to play the male gender role for a little while. She'll start to take control of things. She'll start to boss you around. She'll start to coordinate, lead. All the things that make you feel like a man, she may begin to start doing. And the reason why she's doing this is because she wants to test to make sure that you are going to play the male gender role even if she tries to do it and take control. And she needs to know that she is safe feeling. So she tests you to make sure that while she's feeling and being openly feeling like a woman and fulfilling her female gender role, which is her job, she needs to make sure that you're going to still take control and take charge of the male gender role on your end. If you're both feeling, then the ship sinks. If you're both playing the male gender role and trying to think logically and control and lead, if you're both trying to steer the boat, the ship also sinks. So it's important that one of you plays a role and the other plays the other. What happens in gender role reversal is if you don't pass a test, if she begins to play the male gender role and you essentially say, okay, well, you can do that then, whatever. I'm going to go over here and hang out. If you do that, then she will continue to play the male gender role, and you will naturally start to play the female gender role. And then what happens is you begin to get extremely weak, and you begin to shift all of your power away and all the things that make you feel like a man. And then she begins to take on all that control of the relationship. Now, she doesn't necessarily want that to happen either. She doesn't want to control the relationship. She wants to trust you to control the relationship. But if you're not doing it, and every time someone challenges you, you back down and let them take over, then she can't trust you, and she can't feel openly around you. And so you have gender role reversal, where she begins to actually play the male gender role, and you begin to actually play the female gender role. But because it's neither of what you want, it's not what she wants, and it's not what you want, you begin to blame her for all of your problems, and she begins to blame you for all of her problems. And eventually, the relationship completely explodes and falls to pieces. Not understanding and taking control of gender roles will be the deciding factor of whether or not you, as a man, naturally are attracting the women that you want, or if you are constantly attracting women that aren't what you want and don't allow you to play the dominant male role. If you're having a very hard time and you keep – basically, if you have a hard time leading an interaction, I can guarantee you that you are accidentally playing the female gender role. If women constantly lead interactions, if women are the ones to approach you, if women are the ones that move forward with the relationship, that make many logical decisions in the relationship, you aren't doing a very good job at it. And this is the number one focal point for you as a man, is to make sure, the bottom line, the very least, you're constantly playing your male gender role.